Hey there, everyone. It's Eizen the Broniac here, and welcome one and all, at long last, finally, for something that should have happened last year, and I'm going to double down on it this year to make up for it. The official start to Mega Man March Madness 2017. So, of course, before I dive into the first game here, I have to admit to something. Growing up, I was never the biggest Mega Man fan, mainly because I wanted to be a Mega Man fan, but didn't have the money to buy the games. So I had to wait until my college years, mainly because I needed my own computer to get my own Mega Man ROMs to play with emulators. So why am I bringing this up? Up until now, I've never played the Game Boy games. So you know what? What better way to start than with this? So just to make sure the controls work, yes they do. So let's get started with this. The only thing I can remember from this is that, unlike the regular NES games, rather than 6 Robot Masters, you know, since this is 1, or in the later series, 8, you actually start with half of that, which is 4. So we're nixing out Gutsman and Bombman in order just to keep Cutman, Iceman, Fireman, and Electman. So naturally, if their weaknesses are still the same, I'm going to start with Cutman and work my way through there. Let's see how long that lasts. But yes, let's start with my personal favorite Robot Master, at least from one, which would be Cutman. So obviously, same controls that you would expect from a regular Mega Man game, which is just jump and shoot. Okay, I wonder if this game's trying to tell me something. Also, I'm getting the feeling that this is a conveyor belt. And yes, before you, wonder about anything. I do want that one up because, you know, I've never played this game before. Who's to say I'm automatically gonna be a Mega Man master at this game? I for one, sure know that's not gonna be the case. I'm gonna need every bit of help I can get.
Get that out of the way.
Ah, jeez. Okay, you know what? I was gonna kill that, but you're just moving way too fast for me, buddy. There we go. Okay, so just jumping and shooting our way through this. So that's clearly how you survive these battles. And that, my friends, is why I always grab the one-ups. Oh, god damn it. That's not even a halfway point. I repeat, this is why you grab the one-ups. Or rather, this is why I'm grabbing the one-ups. Because I clearly know what I'm doing. That's why I got killed so early on. Ah, damn it. Thought I was far enough in between it that I wouldn't take the damage. I guess wrong. Not that it's gonna matter much. Yeet. Butthole. Oh, What am I doing? Question of the day, folks. What the hell am I doing? Also, this is my own video commentary. Why am I not talking? Answer, I don't know. There we go. Yay, now I'm able to progress onward again, and, that slider thingy just despawned. And yes, this is monotonous as all hell, but I just feel like doing it because, you know, why not? And, of course, it's our good friend, get hit by everything you possibly can, man. Aha! When you find the safe spot, exploit it. Kinda makes me wish I thought about it early on. Oh, God. Note to self. They cannot be killed. Okay. Oh god, big eye. Oh jeez. They found a way how to make him deadlier. He can only be hurt if you shoot him when he's jumping. Granted, that's one way how to make him scarier. Alright, if I do this... I was gonna say, if I do this properly, I can avoid taking a hit. We all know how that went, and wow! And I made it all the way to... Cutman. Only took me one extra life. Okay, show of hands out there, who saw that coming? Seriously, show of hands out there. Who thought that I sucked so much balls? Ah. Cutman, you... You magnificent bastard, you. Oh, God. Oh, jeez! You know what? It's a survivor achievement, but I'll take it, damn it. And this is why you saved those extra lives, because that's practically the equivalent of me going through it without dying, even though we saw it. And, can we scroll away from the screen? That's a bit scary. And there's our password screen, which we will most likely never use, because I am actually using this, via emulator, so I get a save state. And also, minor detail, but notice a bit of gray was showing, so let's move that up. Okay, so next up, logically speaking, if this is going with the same logic, Rolling Cutter is the weakness of Elecman, so let's go after him next. Elecman Sentai Pose, go! And we got the leaf lowers here. Okay, I think I got that down. Wow. Pretty much the safest position I could be in, and I royally screw it up. Obviously, I'm the best Mega Man Let's Player ever. Seriously, best Mega Man Let's Play ever. Because I just walked right into that. Okay, so, up there. Let's go down there, and over there. Okay. Woo! Yeah! That's how you do a Yoku puzzle, man. And this time we'll stay far enough away. We don't get hit by that. Ah, great! Because one Yoku puzzle was clearly not a challenge for me. Let's add a fan to it. I know I landed on that just fine, but that should have killed me there. And by kill me, I mean at least hurt me. Ugh, there we go. Who needs that last jump there, I tell you? I don't. Come on, move out of the way. Ladies and gentlemen, I are best Mega Man player. Clearly, I can rock with the best. I mean, seriously, the rate I'm going, I'm about as... Wait a minute! An Airman enemy on a Lekman stage? Blasphemy! Also, I already forgot what their name is, but these guys are much deadlier in the sense that rather than arc it upwards towards you, they just toss it horizontally. Yeah, horizontally towards you. In all fairness, that actually makes them more menacing. Also, I probably get the feeling I could, you know, just jump all the way to that one, or, you know, that one too. Because why overcomplicate something when you can overcomplicate something? I don't know. I'm just trying to go with the flow there of how you do this. because, you know, this isn't stressful enough. But of course, with enough timing and patience, anyone can easily get through a situation like that. Nope. I think this is the game trying to give me an apology letter. I mean, seriously, why else would it give me a 1-up when I'm just about ready to go up against a Lekman here? Oh, jeez. And granted, I'm glad those don't actually shoot elect beams, but... Or at least the stage has an equivalent of elect beams. Because Lord knows, that would make that room so much harder. Defeat the Susies while killing... kill the Susies while dodging the elect beams. Oh no! My biggest enemy yet! The Big Eye! Oh, or that. Man, they shoot a whole lot faster than I. Could you please move? Could you please move? Oh, jeez. No one was coming that you know what, screw it. I was gonna try and grind for some health points, but at this point, not really worth it. So let's just we'll use the rolling cutter once. Or, you know, three times. That works twice, and by three times I mean let him hit three times and only use it twice, and I would still win. So again, pretty much the equivalent of the last stage, where I managed to survive while technically not losing any lives, but we saw it. And we all know that's not Thunder Beam, it's Elect Beam. Get it right. So, once again, if we're going off of the right order, somehow Thunder can pierce through Ice Glacier, so Iceman it is. Because, you know, Arnold Schwarzenegger said it best, the Iceman cometh. Oh god, not the Buster Bladers! Not the Buster Bladers! I love Mega Man games, but I even... There's you can find the most hardcore Mega Man fan who loves everything about the game and find at least one thing he hates. Buster Bladers, easily the most hated enemy. If not of all time, at least my personal heart. And also, how did I go from just sliding into that enemy? But let's see if I can do it again. Oh, okay, I see it. At first I thought, it's like, I'm just jumping from up here. How do you reach that? But as I'm jumping, it'll let me do it again. Fine, make a liar out of me. Why don't you, game? What I saw was that as I was moving right here, I turned it aside, and moving on, we're here. This moment has pissed me off even more so than necessary. Oh god. Stop. Stop it with the sliding. And we're already at a halfway point! I'm curious about something. That's what I thought. You know what? I wasn't a safe enough environment. I was gonna say, how did it not notice me there? Stop, 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 stop it with the sliding. Thank you, game. I would very much appreciate it if you were to stop sliding. Why couldn't you move me forward there? Okay, seriously, could you stop it with all the slip and slide nonsense? This is not the slip and slide. As far as I can tell, it's not produced by Whammo. Ah, there we go. Run and start helps me get through. And thank you for your apology there, game. It's taking back the apology there, folks. It's clearly taking back the apology, because... And yeah, this is just another thing to teach you, is there no way how I can move forward there? Basically telling you... Move... Move fast, otherwise, that's gonna hurt you. And yeah, you have to use that in order to reach the platform here. But of course, I feel stupid and tempted enough to wait for this. Okay. Okay, I see what I have to do now. If I can stop sliding. I was gonna say, being a dumb dummy. That's clearly not what I was trying to do. Stupid slip and sliding control. Stop being a slip and slide. Okay, seriously. Slip and sliding controls. Stop it. I'm gonna die in the most stupidest death. Death possible! And it's gonna be for all the wrong reasons at the rate you're going. Are we almost at the boss yet? Get! Woo! Okay, Buster Bladers. Oh god, oh god! Stop it with the- Stop it with the slip and slide! Slip and slide How dare you? Not liking the slip and slide here. In fact, this has already gotten, this is already getting my personal vote on most hazardous enemy in the game. It's not the big guy, it's not the Mets, it's not even the Sniper Joes, the Ice. They are my most heinous enemy in the game thus far. Okay. Now we can move forward here. Now, we can actually move forward in here, and you know what? There. I'm actually saving myself some trouble for once. Okay, what the hell, game? Getting this ready again. Ice controls in this game. Seriously, most heinous there. Of course, we may as well continue. What's the point of not continuing it? Okay, these extra lives here at this point, they're not even a faulty here. They're an apology, because I want an apology for this entire stage. And, yeah, they're already full, so no need to do that. And without even trying, we're already at the halfway point. Or at least, we're at a checkpoint. So, just keep attacking the enemies here. Why did you have to run into that? Why did I have to get hit by that? Why? Just why anything in this game? Why? No, actually, that's a bit too harsh. Why anything in this stage? There we go. To be fair, this game's not at fault. The stage, however, that's an entirely different thing. Also, much like before, time, not gonna waste it like a dumb dummy. Also, let's wait until he's done. Okay, seriously, well before I was done, and now almost at the end of the stage already, because I don't know how much more of this ice section I can take without going insane, and I think I finally see the boss shutters. Thank God for that. Please tell me that Iceman is just as easy to kill him. Okay, I was gonna say, what the hell? Why is he not taking any damage from that? But I guess guess I hit him when it wasn't supposed to yet, but at least we finally put the stage behind me. Thank the Lord for that. So with that, we got Ice Slasher Beam. And since we pretty much took care of every other Robot Master at this point, there's nowhere to go but up. Turning up the heat, maybe? Yeah, we're just gonna go after fire, man. I'm sorry for that pun. In fact, there we go. I feel better. And, I don't know, I guess some of these remixes, they're not bad, but they could be better. I mean, in all fairness, there's not really much else that you can do with Game Boy sound effects, but no, you stay away from me, Buster Bladers, and that's a solid. That lava pit, which I would assume is such a bottomless pit, is rather just a solid there. It didn't kill me, so I'm not going to complain, but you'll have to excuse me if I'm not caught off guard by that. Oh, goody, the Hotman producers. Okay. Health pack. That's not a health pack. I could use some health right now. That's not health. That's death. At least the memory serves, this is the start of the room. So, making progress at least. And just like that, we're back to full health. Ow. Could have sworn I jumped on time. Oh well. Let's just continue onward here. Oh, wait a minute. I'm not trying to I can't. Alright, never mind. I'm just gonna try and exploit the whole, if I'm on the edge of the ladder, I can do that. But no, apparently this time around, you can't do that. Only if there's far more ladder left. How the hell did I dodge that? I'm not gonna complain. In all retrospect, I probably should have seen that coming. Whoop! Okay, I get the feeling, unless they really want to drag this out any more so than necessary, the stage should be ending shortly. I'm saying should, as if I know this game. I clearly don't. Ah, of course you put him just out of reach. And yeah, for those of you wondering, this is death. This is Mega Man, oh, damn it! Put the checkpoint so close in the stage that, when you think you're close enough to a new checkpoint, if there even is a checkpoint, for all I know, that's just a halfway point. There are no other checkpoints. If you don't include, boss shutter doors. Anyway, probably for the best. I'm saying Whether or not I defeat Fireman within the next two lives, or until I reach continue, I should say, or if I beat Fireman, that's probably a good place to cut off, because I'm actually... Can I not? Apparently not. Also, this time, I will see that coming, and still run into it. Because I am clearly the best when it comes to dodging the fire that's shooting from the side. Also, watch where the hell you're going. Can you dine out? Thank you. More Buster Bladers. The bane of my existence, let alone any Megaman player's existence. Oh, jeez. Even when I got the timing down, I don't have the timing down. Of course that's not it. Of course that's not it. Why make this stage easier on myself? No, let's just make it even more harder for you. That's what the little kitties want. Aww. I'm complaining about checkpoints in this stage, but I will give it credit for one thing. At least this is less annoying than the tricky as all hell ice platforming. A lot better than the slippery ice platforming. Okay, this time, know when to move forward. See? It's not that difficult if you know what you're doing, Eizen. It's all about timing. Okay, seriously. Ugh. Sprite flickering. Sprite overload, I should say. Calm down. How can I see anything with these glorious, portable 8-bit graphics if you, don't do them properly? What the hell am I talking about? It makes no sense. Ah! Almost got it. Really? I personally judged that, so I would avoid that fate, and I still took the... Why am I not at the boss shutter doors yet? Please tell me that's the boss shutter doors. Now, this is what concerns me. I have practically a little over less than half health. If he takes about as much damage as he does in a normal Mega Man game, I'm kind of boned. Especially if the way he fires his Firestorm attacks the same way. By which I mean, I can dodge the Firestorm, the fire pillars that form after a said Firestorm. That's what gets me killed. Well, one attempt at this. Also, it's not the same way. Not that I'm complaining. I'll take it. I will gladly take it. But at least now, we finally got past all that BS and carry. have Firestorm and Carry. I would give you my thoughts on how I feel about that, but I'm already at like 35 minutes here. I'm just gonna stop it right there. I'll see you next time, folks, for more of Mega Man 1, or otherwise known as the Game Boy version, compared to the Nintendo version, Mega Man World 1. Because, you know, Mega Man 1 and Mega Man Game Boy 1, huge differences there. Huge differences. Okay, I'll talk to you later, guys. Take care, then.